Ladies and gentlemen, please do not be shocked. I did have to shave for a bet that I lost, and I am a man of my word. So you'll see this boyish-looking face for a few days until the beard comes back. But I actually did my hair for once because it finally grew out long enough. So please don't fret. But let's talk about the reverse from Microsoft and Xbox. The Verge has written out that Microsoft backtracks on Xbox Live Gold price hike. Free-to-play games will also no longer require a gold subscription. Geez, it only took them 18 years. But let's continue. Microsoft has reversed its controversial Xbox Live price increase. The company announced a price hike on Friday that would have doubled the cost of a yearly subscription to the service, which is required to play games online on Xbox consoles, to $120 a year for many users. Now, though, Microsoft says the price hike will stay the same. So they're not making it free, they're just not charging you more. So beyond that, Microsoft has decided to bring Xbox Live in line with Sony and Nintendo's online services by dropping the subscription requirement for free-to-play games. Popular free-to-play titles like Fortnite are playable on PlayStation consoles and the Switch without an online subscription, but you still need one for Xbox consoles. Microsoft says it's working hard to deliver the change as soon as possible in the coming months. Wait, hold on. What do you mean it's working hard to deliver the change? You went and made the change to double the price in about a day. Now you're going to take a couple of months before you make the change of what it should have been 18 years ago? Ah, yes. It can't get any better than this. But let's look at Microsoft's statement on their blog post, which The Verge has posted here. Although it is pretty cringy, I'm wondering if that Verge PC build guy is actually still involved in this. Anyways, segue. We messed up today, and you were right to let us know. I have to think to myself, there had to be somebody in that boardroom going, look, maybe this isn't the right thing to do. I don't know, probably, and then getting thrown out of the actual boardroom. But let's continue. Connecting and playing with friends is a vital part of gaming, and we failed to meet the expectations of players who count on it every day. No, you didn't fail to meet the expectations. What you failed to do was understand how much you've been price gouging people for having them connect to your own internet. In fact, I think Asmongold might have said it best.
You already do give him the money! You already give him the money twice! And they're saying I'm gonna fucking get you to pay for your own money! You gotta pay for your own money!
You're literally paying people to pay for their own money. I don't know what expectation you're expecting, Microsoft. As a result, we have decided not to change Xbox Live Gold pricing. We're turning this moment into an opportunity to bring Xbox Live more in line with how we see the player at the center of the experience. If you saw the player at the center of the experience, Live should have been free. The extra stuff on Live is what you could have charged for. Game Pass is the thing that people will pay for. Connecting to the internet should always be free. And I'm not focusing just on Xbox here. I'm looking over at you, Nintendo, and Sony as well for following suit. There's no reason anyone should be paying money to access the internet that they already pay for. For free-to-play games, you will no longer need Xbox Live Gold to play those games on Xbox. We are working hard to deliver this change as soon as possible in the coming months. Like I said before, that should have been instantaneous. I'm pretty sure it's probably just a couple lines of code. Now, I'm armchair devving here, but remember the whole, like, you can't just switch off Kinect, and then they literally just switched off Kinect? It's probably the same thing. They literally could just probably switch off the need for gold for free-to-play games, but hey, you know. Armchair dev and all. If you are an Xbox Live Gold member already, you stay at your current price for the renewal. New and existing members can continue to enjoy Xbox Live Gold for the same price as they pay today. In the US, $9.99 for 1 month, $24.99 for 3, and $39.99 for 6, and $60 for 12 months. The price of a video game for 12 months of connecting to your internet. I mean, you could have actually just bought another video game for that cost that year, couldn't you? That's just me, though. Look, this is honestly great that Microsoft did the turnaround and they did exactly what they should have done from the beginning, which is just make free-to-play games be playable without the need for gold. But instead, they chose this route. Don't cheer this company, right? They got caught with their hand in the cookie jar and they got hit with a huge backlash. This backlash was so big that they literally had to turn around and reverse their decision. But to think that Microsoft has the best intention for gamers is ridiculous. And I've seen that tweet and those comments float around the internet the last couple of days over the weekend. Now, here's the big process too. Don't think that this is a win for you either. Because the thing is, you shouldn't be paying at all to access your own internet. This kind of process is something that people like to do and say, oh, the gamers got a W this time. No, you're still holding a fat L because you're still paying for online connectivity, even though you already pay for your ISP. It's nice of the fact that our outrage was actually able to make Microsoft reverse their changes, because honestly, those changes were ridiculous. And as I said in my past video, they're not doing anything to add value. They're inflating costs to create perceived value. And even then, they're still doing it here. They're just giving you free online multiplayer for specific free-to-play games without the need for gold as a perceived value of them doing a good thing, even though it's going to take a few months for that to actually kick in. My thing is, they've actually already had this plan in development for quite some time. I don't think this is just like, oh, we should just give them free-to-play games for free now. I think they were planning this from the very beginning with to have the price hike and then on top of that, having Game Pass. Now look, Game Pass on its own is a great deal. I'm not denying that. However, 18 years of paying for Xbox Live Gold is not a great deal, and it's not what's best for gamers. What is best for gamers, though, is being vocal, letting these companies know you're not going to put up with their trash, and making sure that if they do something like that, you stick to your guns, you cancel your subs, you hit them where it hurts, and it's the pocketbook. There's no need to harass, but making content like we did before, making those tweets that say, hey, look, this is a bad move, and then canceling subscriptions is what spoke out the most to Xbox. It wasn't them trying to be nice. It was the fact that we went out there and we turned things around because we're not going to take it anymore. Oh, and also, to the bootlickers in my comments section, I wonder how good boots taste, because y'all really be eating a lot of boot lately. If you like the video, go ahead and subscribe. If you like the content, leave a like. Leave a comment. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. I'd love to get your feedback on this. And anything, check me out on Twitch and Twitter. It's at Oh No It's Alex. I'm sorry for not having a stream on Sunday, but we'll go back to streams this week. I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one.